Hello, everyone, and welcome to Oneida News Episode 4. Well, we ran a little bit quick last episode, only around 13 minutes long. And the reason why we did that is we wanted to shorten it down so that you guys had more stuff to do on your Monday night. Now, some people right after the episode was done messaged me and they said, Adam, the episode was too short. You didn't have anything funny in there. Well, that message seemed to go on all week long. We got a lot of people saying, Adam, episode wasn't funny. Adam this, Adam that. Listen, I get it. The show wasn't perfect, but neither was the VBS matinee show during the play. I'm going to get in trouble for that one. Other things that are going on right now. We are in Lent. The Lenten season is upon us. If anyone that's watching that doesn't really know what Lent is all about, it is giving things up that you like. Obviously, it seems like a lot of people must have liked working out because no one goes anymore. tonight's episode, we have got it fully packed up with Cody Watson being on the show doing some really great stuff. Ben or Tim is going to be in a dress later on in the show and a whole lot more. So let's get to episode 4. Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Oneida News. We have a lot to talk about tonight, but we are going to be slowing it down from last week.
We're going to start today's episode off by talking.
I'm just kidding. We're not going to be going that slow, but we are going to be slowing it down just a little bit. We're going to start today's episode off with Mother Nature. She's going to be talking about the weather of the week. Megan Vanderhoof, what's the weather going on this week?
With daylight savings upon us, our mornings will be darker for a while, but our evenings will have a lot more light. Perfect time to get out there and go for the walk that we've all been dying to do. A couple days this week look really good. Tuesday, high of 43 and sunny. Friday, not too shabby at 37 degrees and sunny, but no walking on Thursday night, low of 8. Another sign of spring, Nikki Doodles opened this past weekend. Now, certainly they would not open if they didn't think that spring was right around the corner. So if they can be optimistic, so can we. This has been your Mother Nature Weather Report. I'm Megan Vanderhoof.
And it looks like it's going to be mostly sunny this week. Now, that doesn't mean that it's going to be hot or anything, but most of the days it should have some sunshine. Even if it's in the 30s, it stays pretty warm. Our main story tonight is going to be dealing with Oneida High School. A girl named Katie Carroll has an organization going on called Cut It for Cancer. Now, what this deals with is that the teachers at Oneida High School, they set a price on their hair. Once the price is met, they shave their heads. Some of the teachers' names include Scott Fallon, Matthew Sheen, Jason Fuller, Randy Wilzak, Robert Morano, John Zamparetti, and Steve Dunkel. If you guys are interested or would like to help donate, please get a hold of Katie Carroll, and she will point you in the right direction. So very good, Katie. Thank you so much for giving us that story for this week. Let's turn it over to Abby and Will. Together, they are working as one, just like their marriage. They're going to be talking about sports and health. Abby and Will, what's going on this week?
Spring sports are beginning this week. It's beginning to get warmer outside. So there's a couple things to keep in mind when you're exercising. Whether you're in sports or just trying to stay in shape, it's important to warm up and stretch properly before you begin your exercise. I know that I personally have pulled my hamstring a couple of times from not warming up and being fully stretched out before going 100%. So that's something to keep in mind. And on top of that, whether you're just trying to stay in shape or if you're in sports, it's important to do your cardio exercises, whether that's running or swimming, it could be biking. It's good for your heart and it helps keep you slim. A great place to do that is right there in Oneida at the YMCA.
Yeah, that is a great place to do it. Thanks, Will. And so along with working out, you really want to make sure you're eating healthy, drinking your water. The best time to drink your water is before and after a workout. And if you like your Gatorade, try to only drink it during the workout because it is high in sugar and carbohydrates. A good food to remember to eat after your workout is a protein. So a couple examples, lean fish and chicken, almonds, avocado, a protein shake. This is going to really help to build up that muscle that you broke down during your workout while keeping some of the fat off. This has been your health and sports tip of the week. I'm Abby Payton.
And I'm Will Payton. Back to you.
And there we have sports and health and wellness put together. I don't know. What do you guys think? Let me know. Send me a message. I like Abby and Will having their segment together, having it in one shot. Let me know. If you guys like it, I will keep it. We're going to take a 30-second break. When we come back, we've got Cody Watson on here, and he's going to be a little bit more pumped up for this episode, and you're going to see why. Everyone, and welcome back to Oneida News. So Cody Watson, this is his third week on Oneida News, and some people have said that he is
too bland when he talks, and the next movie that is coming out.
So some people have been saying he's too bland. So he wanted to do something a little bit different to get him pumped up for this week's episode of Oneida News.
All right, Cody, good. 30 seconds in, we're going to go right over to 300.
All right.
On the movie. Really try to bump up that movie. I think it's going to be our good movie of the week.
Definitely, yeah.
Yeah, one thing, though. Bad reviews from last week's episode from you. Go figure, everyone had bad reviews. They're saying you need to be more upbeat. Okay. What do you want to do?
You know what? Go get the jumper cables.
You got it. The jumper cables.
Let's do this.
My name's Cody Watson. This is the Egg Bomb. Hashtag swag. Hashtag YOLO. Hashtag Oneida News. Hashtag new year, new me. This is what Oneida News does. Let's crack that open. Oh, it's been a while since I've had one of these. Here we go. Down the hatch. Okay, this week we have Mr. Peabody and Sherman, a great family-friendly film. I was dying of laughter the entire time. Who can't love a movie where a dog adopts a boy? It's hilarious. Have you ever seen Shrek? You know, a great adult humor with it as well. Next, we have The 300, a great sequel to the original, literally killer movie. I was dying the entire time. I watched it in 3D. I literally felt I had to clean the blood off of my clothes after this movie. And then next week, we have Divergent, the next big film, close to Twilight, starring Shailene Woodley and Theo James. I'm really excited for this one. Tickets are on sale now at the box office at the United Movieplex. Come on in, buy your tickets. We'll see you then. I'm Cody Watson with your Movie Scoop of the Week.
And now Cody Watson has a way of giving us the movie clips of the week in a little bit more of an exciting fashion. So thanks again, Cody, for that. Let's go on over to Ben and Tim. Now, we put up a status a few days ago saying that if I could hit, what was it, 200 and what was it, Tim?
It was 150, then it was like up to 200, and then it was like 250, and then you still broke it.
Yeah, okay. If we broke 250 likes, Ben and Tim would play a game. Whoever lost would have to go to the gas station and pump gas in a dress. So here's the video of Ben and Tim.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to tonight's game of Who Can Put Your Phone on Silent. I'll call you back. Of Who Can Stare at the Other Person Longer. The person who stares longer without blinking
wins, the person that loses has to get in a dress and go to Save-On and pump some gas.
Oh, yeah.
Let us begin in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, begin.
Holy crap. You win, Quentin.
Stay in the band, boys. Stay in the band. Are you crying? Hey,
I can't. A dust follicle just got in my eyeball.
Tim, what's the best case scenario?
Best or worst?
Best.
Best, no one's there.
Worst case scenario?
People are staring at me.
Jim.
You're like, what are you doing?
Aren't you cold?
And thank you so much, Tim, for losing in the game. I know I should probably say congratulations, Ben, but really congratulations, Tim. If you guys go back and watch that video, you'll notice that the people in the background couldn't get their eyes off of Tim. So Molly, looks like you're not the only person that can't get your eyes off of Tim. So thank you again, Ben and Tim. We're going to take another 30-second break. When we come back, we are giving away prizes, and we are going to be giving the names to those prizes.
A buyer of gold and silver coins and jewelry would like to buy your old coin collections and paper money. We have collectors and investors across the country looking for gold coins, old silver dollars, half dollars, quarters, dimes, buffalo nickels, Indian head and wheat pennies, and old paper money. We are also paying top dollar for your old stamp collections, baseball and football cards, and old foreign coins. If it's collectible, we want it. In Cheryl, call 280-0435. In New Hartford, 982-9088.
Visit our store, we'll pay you more.
Hello everyone, and welcome back to Oneida News. This week's winner of the Oneida News t-shirt goes to Gary Johnson. Gary, congratulations on winning the shirt and sharing Oneida News and watching it. Also, we really do appreciate it. Next week on our episode, we've got so much stuff going on. We're going to be bringing out Nikki Doodles. We're going to be getting some interviews with that. We've got a great company on our show. We're going to be bringing back some more Moe's gift cards and a whole lot more. Listen, I'm Adam Vanderhoof, and this is your Oneida News.
With, and wait, so how do I, because what am I talking about?
Nothing. we're just going to cut you out of the segment anyway.
Hold on. Okay, so
I'm Cody Watson with your movie scoop of the week.
Let's go.
Oh my.
Okay.
Stop. No.
You what, Chip?
Oh my god.
I'm